Okay, guys. So it's 10 o'clock now, so let's start. So first of all, I'd like to welcome you all to the class. So if this is your first time, I want to let you know that we meet every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Ireland time, 9 p.m. Egypt, and 10 p.m. Saudi Arabia time. Today I won't be able to open my like turning my camera on because I just came back from I'll mute you all guys, and then after I finish the introduction, I'll let you unmute yourself. So yeah, I was just saying that I won't be able to turn on my camera because I just came back from the dentist and I don't feel well at all. So, but I didn't want to cancel the class today. So I hope you all will speak more than me. So as I said, we meet every Wednesday, and I'd like to welcome you all. 1 minute, I'm just admitting more people. That's great. Like we have Summer, Olivia, Muhammad, Dina, Samasim, Tarek, and Yar. Welcome to you all. Today's topic is about pits. And it's quite interesting. Actually, I don't have a pit, but while I was, trying to prepare this presentation, I find it interesting. So let's start. Just to have a quick introduction about myself. My name is Nancy. I'm originally from Egypt, but I've been living in Ireland for 6 years. Actually, I am in Egypt at the moment. So I'm like spending some time with my family. That's why I canceled the class last Wednesday. So I'd like to apologize to you all. Hopefully, I'll be able to continue till the end of the holiday. About myself, I started my YouTube channel a year and a half ago. And the name is, as you see here on the screen, it's Easy English with Nancy. And I'd love to meet you all on social media, on Facebook and Instagram. I'm a pharmacist, but I shifted my career around 7 years ago to become an English facilitator. Yeah, and that's me. So let's jump to this interesting topic. So anybody, any question? Anyone would want to say anything? What do you think about today's topic? Who would like to speak? So feel free to unmute yourself. Summer, the bravest one. Hi, Summer.
Hello, Nancy. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Well, I miss you so much, Nancy. Congratulations for being with your family.
Oh, thanks very much, Summer. I needed that, after the lockdown and everything. I really need to spend, some time with my family. So, thank
We all need that, Nancy.
Yeah, I
You
know.
don't know when I know you traveled to Egypt, felt that you were here with me in Saudi Arabia and left me alone.
Oh, Summer, you're so sweet.
Believe me, Nancy.
You're so sweet, Summer. No, seriously, I just arrived last week. It was Sunday, and when you just come, the people keep coming to visit you, and I was like, okay, I really need to
Yes, I
to prepare
know.
for the class and everything, but it was hectic, So yeah, I miss you all. Seriously, I really like to run this class. But it's a great, also to be in Egypt. Life is different here than any other place in the world, to be honest. Okay, so Samar, now today, what do you think about today's topic?
You said the bits.
Pits, yes, that's what we're going to talk about. What do you think about that? We have a few questions coming. You know what? I'll let you speak the first one. If you don't mind, I'll let you speak the first one, but I just forgot to go through the group rules. So is that okay? I'll just mute you for 1 minute.
Okay,
I'll go through the group rules and then I'll let you speak the first one. Okay?
no problem.
Okay. Because you know what, Summer, you're always punctual and you're always even like you come even before the class time. So thanks for that.
Thank you, Nancy.
Thank you. Okay, so guys, I'll just go through the class rules, or as I call it, it's a group agreement. So it's accept and respect each other, one voice at a time. So if you like unmuted yourself and you found someone else is speaking, just give them the chance to speak. Speak only in English, and you have a maximum of 3 minutes to speak. And you, like, you can speak again, but I'm just trying to give everyone a chance to speak. I always say this is a judgment-free zone, so feel free to make mistakes, and it's all about your progress, not perfection, okay? So if you are in a low level from your own perspective and you are in a higher level tomorrow, this is a progress. So do your personal best effort, okay? And no one here is going to judge you or say that your, you know, your English is bad or something like that. No, at least not, I can guarantee, not in my class. So these are the group rules. If you are okay with it, just type yes in the chat box, and then let's jump to the first question. So what do you think? Is that okay? Do you all agree? Okay, so Yara said yes. That's great. Okay. And now let's go to the first question. So, Summer, do you have a pet? If you do, how old is it? Where did you get it from? Who takes care of it? What does it look like? And what do you feed it? Like, the question is on the screen. So just unmute yourself, Summer, and answer the question.
Already, I have two pets.
Two pets, okay.
two pets. Nadine and Farida, my daughters.
Okay, this is a good one. Okay, so, I'm not sure if all these questions apply to your daughters. I don't want them to get mad at me. Mommy just said. Okay, have you ever had a pet? A real pet? Hello, Samar?
Because I am... Hello, Nancy.
Yeah.
Hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now. Yes. Hello, Samar?
Hello, Nancy.
Yes. Yes, now I can hear you. It's just the... I couldn't hear you.
Huh?
Yeah, go ahead.
Speak?
Yes.
I am very...
I don't think I can hear you. Can others hear Summer? Because I just hear you when you start speaking, and then I lost. Okay, Yara, we can. Yara also can hear you. I don't know what's the problem, Summer. So you can hear me well, Summer?
You hear me now?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Speak.
Yes. Go ahead.
I speak now?
Yeah.
I said that I am very afraid of being with them in the same place of any animal, or they were beside me. I can't touch them.
Okay.
They can't be in the roof while there be like chicken, dogs, the pigeon. I am very coward, Nancy. I don't.
No, don't say that. You're okay.
No, I can't deal with them anyway.
Okay. Why is that? Like, how do you feel if there is an animal in the room? Even cats, even birds, something like that?
Any animal, any.
Okay.
Cats, birds,
Okay.
Any bits movement on.
Okay.
Beside me. Phobia.
Oh, phobia.
Suffer
okay.
from phobia.
Okay. So you feel like you panic?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay, so this, I'm not sure if this, but maybe you would like to hear others talking about pets. Maybe this will encourage you not, at least not to be scared. What do you think?
I didn't think so.
Okay, then let's listen to others. What do they think about pets? Is that okay, Summer?
Okay,
yeah.
I said that before. The only bits I deal with them, my daughters. Only.
Oh, That's a good one. Thanks very much, Summer, for your participation. And you know what? You're brave to say that, like, live. Yeah, I really like that you're, you know, like, you just speak. We have Olivia here, unmuted herself. Olivia, would you like to speak?
Hi.
How are you, Olivia?
I miss you from the previous week. So
thanks very much.
Welcome back.
I miss you all, guys. Thanks very much.
Okay.
So tell me, Olivia, do you have a pit?
I had a pit. It was a cat.
Okay.
Okay, but I see it's a very hard responsibility, as you have to feed it to take care of them.
Yeah, of course.
So I don't prefer to be, to have responsibilities, or
take responsibilities.
I breathe. Sorry.
It's okay.
Okay. I'm a little nervous, as I have midterms in the next week.
Okay.
In my college, so I'm a little nervous.
So you're gonna be fine. We believe you, Olivia. You're gonna be okay.
I need someone to tell me that he is trusting me.
Hopefully we'll be running this class until you finish the university, and then you will graduate, and you will tell us that you work maybe in a bank or something, or your dream job, and you will do just fine. You'll be perfect.
Thank you.
Okay, I have a question for you. How old was your cat?
Was 3 years, I think, or 2 years. I think.
Okay, and what happened? Like, did you give her or him to a friend or something?
Again, please.
I mean, like, did you give the cat to a friend or something when you decided that you can't take the responsibility of, you know, having it at home?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, and you think it's okay for a pet, like, to have, like, different owners?
Again, please.
Do you think it's okay for the pit to have different owners? I mean, like, what do you think?
No, of course not.
Yeah,
of course not. But the different owner can be careful with it more than me.
Okay.
So I don't prefer to have a pet like right now. Actually.
Okay. And did your cat have a name? Okay. Was it funny? It sounds funny.
I called it Jamalat.
Okay, that's absolutely funny. Okay, why did you choose this name? Maybe you just felt like
she looks like Jamalat.
She's
Jamalat.
Okay, that's funny. I never heard of a cat named Jamalat. And does your friend still keep the name?
I don't know, but okay. Actually, of course, we'll change it. Of course.
Okay.
No one calls a cat with Jamalat.
Yeah, I never heard of one. Okay, that's funny. Olivia, thank you very much for your participation. So you're the first one here in the class who had a pit. Thanks for your participation. And yeah, you know what? You actually. I said something about the next, one of the questions about the pros and cons of having, or the advantages and disadvantages of having a pit. One of which, of the cons or the disadvantage is, that you have to take responsibility of it. So it's financial time commitment. So yeah, I believe it's not that easy, you know. It's not just bringing an animal to live with you at home. Not like that at all. Yeah. Of course. Thanks, okay. Olivia. And that's good luck with your exams. You're going to be just fine.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Now we have Dina. Hello, Dina. Feel free to unmute yourself, Dina.
Hello, Nancy.
Hi, how are you?
Hello.
Hello, Dina. I can hear you.
Hello, do you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, yes.
Hello.
I can hear you, Dina.
It's guys, Nancy.
I can hear you.
Okay. I can't hear you clearly.
Okay.
Hello, how are you? Now.
Okay, you can hear me now.
Yes.
Okay, great.
Yeah, how are you?
I'm good, Dina.
How did you do, miss?
I'm
so good.
I'm good. Welcome.
Actually, I'm waiting for you last session.
Oh, I'm really sorry. I just apologize. I couldn't make it to the class last week, but we're here today, and hopefully we will be here next week. So tell me, Dina, do you have a pit?
So, actually, no. Actually, my mother and my mother hit cats and dogs, okay. And everything. Yeah.
And why do you think that?
What?
Well, why do you think your mom hates animals? I can hear you, Dina. Okay, I think Dina has a problem with the connection. Maybe we get back to her later. Guys, can you all hear me? Just type yes in the chat box if you can hear me well. Because I just want to make sure it's just a problem with Dina. Okay, so Samar, thanks, Samar. Yeah, great. Okay, now we have who would like to, guys, who would like to participate, just raise your hand or, yeah. So we have Samatham. Hello, Samatham, how are you?
How are you, Ms. Nancy?
I'm good, how are you?
Fine, thank you. I miss you so much.
I miss you too. I miss you all very much. I miss the class. You are all amazing. And I really like it last week. I'm sorry about
even,
that.
The class before the last time, I was missing the class. I opened it 11 o'clock, not 10. So I miss it.
Oh, yeah. I remember. Yes, you and your two Abdullah brothers. Yes, you didn't join the last class, but you hope you are with us today, so that is great. Mm-hmm. Now tell me. What do you think of today's topic?
So about cats and dogs, I so be scared of them.
Okay.
But I have a fish.
You have a fish. Oh, that's great. And
yeah.
You like it.
Yeah, I like it, but even I get scared of it. So when I eat, when I put for the for baby, her name's Baby.
Okay. Oh, nice.
Yeah. So when I put food for her, I be scared even.
Oh, really? Do you think she's gonna bite you or something?
Yeah, I got so scared. Even from pet, all of the pets, but only fish, I'm not scared from it so much.
Okay. And why do you think, why do you get scared? Don't you think that people who have cats or dogs at home, they train them well and they will never, I know that, I believe that a dog will never bite his arm or something, you know?
Like this, I don't know, but I got so scared. Like we have birds for my brother Abdullah and Tariq. They have birds. I got so scared of them.
Okay, yeah. And you think it's like
from when I was a baby, I was get scared of them.
Okay.
So yeah, even my grandmother and grandfather, they have on their garden, a small garden in their house, they put in it a chicken.
Okay, roaster. Deek is roaster.
Yeah, roaster. Yeah, even birds.
Okay, and you get scared of it as well?
Oh, and rabbits. Oh, so wow. They have so much like this, but even I was get scared of them.
Okay. Yeah, and you think it's, is it as bad as summer? It gets like something like phobia, like you get panicked, or you can like deal with it?
No, but when I was grade 7 and 6, I I cry like my brother Abdullah. You know, really? Yeah, she take the aunt and he take the aunt and let me scare of it.
Aunt, okay, yeah, but
even the aunt, yeah, I got very scared of them.
Yeah, but insects are another story, to be honest. They are not pets. They're not, you know, like animals.
No, really, in YouTube, there's a man. There's a man that they got ants. Okay. Pets like ants. They have a clear house. Like there's food. She is ants.
Okay, I know the ants, but can you tell me more about that?
Like a house, clear house. Okay. And she and he bring ants. Okay. And give to them food and water, everything. Okay. Ants, like for 100 ants. Or like this.
Okay.
Yeah, you can open on YouTube.
Yeah, I can take that. I will,
if you want, I will message to you the video, the link of the video.
Please do that. Yeah, put it on the page. Yeah.
Okay.
That's great. Thanks very much for your participation.
You're welcome.
Oh, thank you. Oh, that's great. I never expected someone to, you know, hold an ant or something. Okay, Alia, hello. I see that you want to participate. How are you?
Good.
Alia, how old are you?
I am Aya.
Aya, sorry. I see Alia written here.
She's my daughter.
Okay. Okay, welcome.
Participate.
Great, welcome to the class. So, who would like to speak, the mom or the daughter?
Me, Aya.
Aya, okay, Aya. How are you today? What do you think about today's topic?
That's good.
Okay, so do you like pets or do you like animals?
I like animals so much.
Very good. So you're the bravest one here. All the other people who spoke, sorry guys, no offense, but you know, she's the first one who said that she can deal with animals so far. Oh, tell me, Aya, do you have a pet?
I used to have a pet, but they all died.
Oh, okay. What did you have? What kind of pet?
Well, I don't have pets that kind that go out of the cage because my mom is scared of pets that go all around the house.
Okay.
So we used to have 4 little baby turtles.
Oh, okay. Is it the one that lives in water or the one that lives in, you know?
The ones that have that, like the ones that live in both, but that have nails, long, sharp nails. And okay. For my surprise, they walk very fast.
Oh, okay. And what color were they?
They like broccoli.
Oh, okay. So it's like dark green.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. You know what? I used to have baby turtles as well. Like I had 2, but they both died. I don't know. Mm-hmm. Like I didn't do anything wrong, but they died. But they used to live in the water.
Yeah, well, my mom to bring baby turtles. We wanted big turtles, but my mom is scared of big turtles.
yeah, okay. Yeah, so, and did you, have you got anything other than the turtles or just those ones?
I got 2 birds.
Birds? Oh, that's great, okay.
And I always hear that birds are cute, they love each other, but
the gift for
it was a gift from my dad.
Oh,
and
that's so sweet.
And they always fight.
Yeah, maybe because they are in the cage. I don't know. Like I don't have like much knowledge about birds, but maybe because they are inside the cage and just the 2 of them, small space, I'm not sure.
No, the cage is so big.
Okay.
And they're so loud and I hated them.
Oh, really? And do they like miss the place around them? Like the feathers everywhere? Noisy. Okay. Yeah, I believe they are. And can you sleep at night with this noise?
Yes.
Okay. So you get used to them.
Yes.
Okay, great. And do you like having them around?
Yes, I used to before, like, to, I was always walking to school and I see so many sometimes pigeons can't fly, so I hold them and get back to house and like, can I
oh, they can't fly. Really?
Yes.
And do they have a name?
No, like my mom say no and I leave them outside.
Oh yeah, but I mean like did you give them names?
Yes.
Yeah, what do you call them? Would you like to tell us their names?
Yes. Fifi.
Oh, nice one. Okay, and the other one? Susu.
Susu.
Really? Yes. I can guess well. Well guessed. Oh, that's lovely names. I really like them.
So like there was a consequence which happened. So my brother was young and he opened the cage by a mistake.
Oh.
One of the birds flied out, but they didn't get out.
Okay.
They can't fly very well. So like,
okay.
You know, so they floated.
Okay. And they just float inside the house.
And then bring them back.
Oh, okay. And you still have them, right?
No.
Oh, no.
We used to have them in Sudan called... we don't have passports for them, so we... left him.
Okay. And do you mind me asking, Aya, how old are you?
15 years old.
You're 15? Really? Okay.
Yes.
Your voice sounds younger. Which is a good thing, by the way. Okay. Aya, thanks very much for your participation. And thanks for telling us about your birds. Now let's see who else would like to speak. Oh, thank you. And now let's jump to the next question and see who would like to participate with us. So if you don't have a pet, why not? Would you ever consider getting a pet? Did you grow with pets in your home? So who would like to participate? We have Abdullah. Hello, Abdullah. Feel free to unmute yourself.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Hello, Miss. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks very much for asking. So what do you think, Abdullah, about today's topic? Do you like pets or do you like animals?
I like the dogs and the cats. I like the cat very much, but dog, I have sensitivity.
Okay, so you're allergy. We call it allergy.
Allergy.
Yeah, allergy.
I have two birds.
You have two birds, okay.
And the lift... old. I have two turtle water, and the time this I have desert turtle.
Do you have all these animals in the house?
No, for all time I have two turtle water, but he died. And this time I have two birds and one turtle.
Okay.
Turtle dessert.
Oh, that's great. And your mom is okay with having pets in the house?
Yes, but the cat, no.
She gets bored,
like my sister.
Okay. And what about your siblings? What about Sama and Taref? Do they like pets? Well, actually, Sama...
My brother likes the dogs.
Okay. Oh, dogs. Okay. But I bet your mom won't let you get a dog at home, right?
She likes cat, but my dad and my brother love the dogs.
Yeah, yeah. And would you consider buying a dog or having a dog?
What?
Would you like to have a dog in the future?
I want, but I can't. I got sensitivity.
Yeah, you told me that. Yes, sorry. I just forgot about that. I'm sorry. Yeah, so you said you were allergic to the dogs. You know what? Abdullah, this is one of the disadvantage of having pets inside the house, because sometimes you don't even know that you're allergic to, you know, to cats or dogs or any other animal. And you only realize that after you have it, you know, at home. So it's good at least. How did you know that you're allergic to dogs?
My eyes, it gets big. Oh. And I can't smell nice.
Oh, really? Okay. Oh yeah, and did
you I have ضيق تنفس.
Okay, difficulty breathing.
Like rubble.
Like asthma, okay? Rubble is asthma, okay? And asthma. And it's difficulty breathing, or it's like when you can't
breathe. My eyes get big and I can I breathe not good, hardly.
Okay, wow. Yeah. So it's at least it's good that you know. Yeah, you know that. So yeah, stay away from dogs then.
Always I got the dogs and I get.
Yeah, you get what? Sorry.
When I get with him, I get sick and okay. I have sensitivity. Yeah. I can't smell and like this. I have it always.
Yeah.
When I come to the dogs.
Okay, so you better stay away from dogs. Don't get in contact with them at all, Abdullah.
Yeah, of sure. Yeah. I love the rabbit, but it is very delicious.
It's very what?
Delicious.
Delicious. Okay, eat rabbit.
The rabbit.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Great. Thanks very much, Abdullah, for your participation.
I want to ask a question.
Of course. Go ahead.
How I get more. Be good in English.
Okay, you know what? Can you, well, Samasim will send me something on my page, okay? So you send me also your question and I will answer you there, okay? Because I'm just trying to stay focused on today's topic to give like more people chance to speak, but I will answer your question on the page if you don't mind. Is that okay, Abdullah?
Okay.
Thanks very much for your
thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Okay. Now, who else would like to speak? We have Ahmed. We have Isra. We have Usama. Yara. Yara, I think you said you want to speak next. I just missed it in the chat. Yara, would like to speak? If so, unmute yourself.
Hi, my name is Yara.
Hello, Yara. How are you?
I'm fine.
Is this your first look, time?
It's my first time.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
It's my first time and I have a little difficult in to talk, okay?
You're doing just great. Don't worry.
Thanks. Actually, I don't have a pet because my mom... afraid from cats and dogs.
Okay.
But I like them very much.
Okay.
My friends have cats.
Okay.
And I go to play with it.
Oh, that's great.
And I have one when I was 6 years old, but it lives with my friends in Saudi Arabia.
Okay.
It lives with them and I go and play with it. You know,
okay.
It calls mushakis,
okay,
like the one in Cinderella story.
Okay, and what did you give
it
her?
It was a black one.
Is he a boy? So he's a boy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
It was a naughty one.
Okay.
He moves a lot.
Okay, so that's why you give him that.
Actually,
name.
Yes, he was like mushakis. Typical.
Okay. Yeah. So you know, people always say that maybe there is a story behind choosing, you know, some name for their pits. And I see that you chose Mushakis because, like, he's very nosy and not listening to you, moves a lot.
Yes, and he play a lot, actually.
Okay.
He just jumped from bed to bed, from... to television anywhere he just jump like rabbit.
Okay, so he likes to make a mess.
What
he likes to make a mess, he likes to mess up the place.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, but you actually you don't have a pit right now.
No, I just play with my friend's pets.
Okay. Okay. Where, Yara, where did you go? Yeah, you just muted yourself.
Sorry.
No, that's okay. But thanks very much, Yara, for your participation. And your English is great, by the way.
Thanks.
Okay. And we will be waiting for you next Wednesday at the same time.
Okay.
Join us. Okay. Thanks, Yara. Okay. Now let's see. Let's go to the next question. Now. Okay. So what are the pros and cons of keeping a pet? Pros and cons, the meaning of pros and cons are advantages and disadvantages. So pros mean advantages and cons mean disadvantages. So what are the pros and cons, or what are the advantages and disadvantages of keeping a pet? Actually, some of you already mentioned few of them. So who would like to speak? Tarek? Hello, Tarek.
Me. Hi, hello.
How are you, Tarek?
I'm fine, and you?
I'm good, thanks very much for asking. Tell me, Tarek, can you tell me some of the advantages and disadvantages of having a pet?
I don't understand.
Okay. There is some some good things that you like, you know, when you have a pet, or good things that happen when you have a pet. And there are also some bad things. So can you tell us some good things about having a pet, which we call advantages, or some bad things that happen when you have a pet? If you find this question difficult, if you find it difficult, you can actually talk about it. Yeah.
Okay. The bad things, clean a lot.
Yes. Okay. Yes, you're very, very right. So you have to clean after them all the time. Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I want to put for them food and water.
Yeah. Yeah, you're absolutely right. So if you remember, it's as Olivia said. So she said it's like a responsibility. Like you have to take a responsibility of feeding them, keeping an eye on them so they don't hurt themselves or they don't mess up the place. So it's a responsibility. What else?
Miss, I was have a dog.
Okay.
Malmo Tusky.
Okay.
I don't know what for what he died. He died, but I don't know. Oh. Next day, I bring him. Next day, he died.
Really? Oh, that's weird. And how old was it?
Yeah. I don't know. When he is 46.
46?
46 month day.
Okay. So just a baby dog. That's weird. And you didn't you still didn't know why he died or how he died.
No, I know now. I don't know. I don't know when he died. Why?
Okay.
But now I know.
Okay, so you didn't know, but now you know. So would you like to tell us what happened?
I see on YouTube. Yeah. Okay. The first thing, he has a virus when he has a virus.
Okay.
Because he is small.
Oh, okay.
Baby.
Yeah.
And the next thing, he was sad because I take him from her mom.
Okay.
And dad. She was 46 days because okay. this.
Yeah, he was very young. That's very sad, Tariq, right? But I think now you can't have a dog because Abdullah is allergic Hello. To dogs. I can hear you. Okay, so it seems like
Tariq Okay, has... I want...
Oh. Hello, Tariq. Okay, I think Tariq might have a problem with the connection. Okay, so who else would like to tell us some of the pros and cons of keeping a dog? We have here Isra.
I want.
Oh, okay. So Tariq's back. Go ahead, Tariq.
Hello.
Yeah. I can hear you.
Okay. I am thinking now. I want to bring a dog in the future.
Okay. Yeah, but you'll have to leave the house before because you can't bring it now when Abdullah is allergic, right?
No, I want to put it out in our okay. garden.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So
I want to bring him 4 months.
Ah, okay. Yeah, so good luck with that.
A little bit big.
Yeah, dogs are
like, thank you.
They are very loyal and they are great friends.
And I was have a parrot.
A parrot, really? And was he talking?
Yeah.
Okay. What?
The last time, but he died.
Oh, okay. That's sad.
Before he died. He was talking a little bit and do like, he don't talk a lot.
Okay, okay. Oh, that's weird. I thought all parrots and talk a lot.
I don't understand him.
Okay, yeah. But now you only have the turtle and two birds, right, Tariq?
We have... the birds for my brother.
Okay.
And the turtle for my brother.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. Well, that's great, Tariq. Thanks very much for your participation and telling us about your dog. And hopefully you will get another dog in the future. You will be great friends.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Now,
yeah.
Oh, we'll have Hanan. Hello, Hanan.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Hello, Hanan, how are you?
Hello, hi, Nancy, how are you? I'm good.
I'm good, thanks very much. Tell us, Hanan, what do you think about the pros and cons of keeping a pet? Okay. Or you can answer the next, whatever you want.
First of all, I want to say that we really missed you last week. I feel you made a kind of ambience around our memory that there is something good is going to happen on every Wednesday.
Oh.
So I'm eagerly waiting for that event is going to happen. So once I look at my mobile, it's ringing like an alarm that there is a meeting with Nancy.
Oh.
So I found that you're not there. Really, we missed you.
So
really, I missed you so much.
And thanks very much, Hanan.
But I'm really feeling happy that you are among your family, with your children. I'm really happy that you did.
Thank you. Thanks very much, Hanan. That's like one of the sweetest things that I heard today. Thank you.
Honey, I love you too. For the pets, since I was in grade two, my father had a dog. It's a kind of this police. They used to use them in the police searching or something like this. It's a German Shepherd. It lived with us for a long time at home, we used to play with it. It used to like shake hands and hug. But the most emotional point that when it started to get old and they said they have to shoot it. And they have to come and take it. We started to cry.
Of course.
And it was holding the doors and the gates like it's a human being doesn't want to leave the house. And once you, I've heard your, or I read your topic, I remembered that point, that moment. I didn't forget it at all.
I know.
So since that time, my dad never put any or gained any a kind of pit at all. Never.
Of course.
My son used to have a turtle. It's living in a tank, and he gave it a name, Sutuhi. So because it used to float on the surface of the water, so he used to call it Sutuhi because it's on the surface of the water.
That's a nice name.
Yes, no, but it's not better than Jamalat.
Oh yeah,
Jamalat. This is the icon of today. Yes.
But you know the Jamalat best thing is that every pit's name has a story. I think which is funny, or I don't know, like it's interesting to hear all these stories about pits' names.
Because she told you the reason. She said that it's like Jamalat. Who's Jamalat? How is she like? I don't know.
Well, but I just imagined her cat maybe wearing, you know, something like a floral scarf kind of thing. I don't know.
maybe there's a very good question that I've read here. What do you think of people who own dangerous animals? And that is a very sometimes question that is in my mind. I'm thinking about this when I go to the pit store. I find that they are selling snakes, rats, tigers,
really?
many of these kinds. Yes, here I know there is a villa next to our house. They own a tiger, and I hear the sound. Sometimes I told my children maybe it's a lion. They said no, mommy. We know the friends here, that we have friends in this villa, and it's a kind of tiger.
Okay.
I don't know how. How can these people live with such dangerous animals?
Animal,
it's something risky. I don't know.
I think so. It's scary, you know, even the idea.
Yes,
waking up and find a tiger beside my bed. Oh my God, no.
When we had some tank, and this tank, there's some fish, and the fish is something delicate, and you can feel it's something funny. You watch it, relax when you watch it. But I watch a tiger, or if I watch a snake living with me at home, how can I? I don't know what is this kind of feeling. It's something really weird.
I don't know, but I think people just get used to it. You know, like anything, that it's hard at the beginning, and they just get used to it. But I'm not sure. Like, this is supposed to be a wild animal, so I'm not sure if they can be nice to you all the time. Like I've heard, like a lot of you know, in a lot of incidents or accidents, that maybe a lion eats his coat or a trainer. So, well, you can't trust them. They also have moods, and they get, you know, aggressive sometimes. So I'm not sure about that,
true,
to be honest.
Yes. Those people who live in the circus, they are used to deal with such animals. But I think after some time, they are getting old. And when they are getting old, they start to be aggressive, or getting wild. Try to eat who is there, whoever is there. If this is the person they get used to live with, or whoever. And I think most people heard about many accidents happen in the circus. And this is not house, not a home to live with.
Yeah,
so what may happen if I open my eyes in the morning and I see a lion next to me is living and is sleeping in the bed? I don't know. How can they...
I don't know, to be honest. Maybe would someone here in the class owning some dangerous animals, we can ask them.
I don't know. Sure. Yes, please. Please, if there is, let them or her talk to us.
And even see some people here, they mentioned that they even get scared of dogs or cats.
Or, you know, some of I need you guys to help me match the colors.
Okay. Oh, sorry, someone is here. Yeah. So I'm not sure about what about dangerous animals. Yeah, and see, so you see here, even I found this picture here, if you can see on the screen, I'm not a house cat. So I think even the feeling of the wild animals when you just keep them home.
Yes, it will live and according to its nature. Yes. So its nature is to attack other animals or other creatures.
Yeah.
So how can I change its nature to an my nature or people's or human beings' nature?
Yeah.
It's not easy. Yeah. Even if we train them, if we practice them, they will do for some time, but their nature will
might change.
Will be there. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, thanks, Haran. Yes, I totally agree with you. And thanks for actually answering this question. Now I have, I'll just go through the last question. It's I find it's interesting. It's a debate. I'd like someone to tell me if he agrees or she agrees with putting animals in cages or in captivity. I'd like someone to, if someone agrees with that and someone disagree, let's have a debate. So who would like to participate? Haran, would you like to participate in that? Because I don't see anyone raising.
Sure.
Okay. And then let me see. We have here Osama, Asma, and Isra. Who would like to participate?
Hello.
Hello. Hello, Osama. How are you?
How are you, Islamti?
I'm good, thanks.
Hope you are fine.
Yes, I am very well. Yeah. Egypt is great. no lockdown here.
we all felt disappointed when we found that you wouldn't be online the last week. As Ms. said, all of us missed you very much.
Thank you very much, Osama. I really wish if I can make it.
You make a small familiar community, really. Really, thanks for your
Thank you very much, Osama. I'm really happy to hear that from you guys. Thank you. So, Osama, tell me, would you like to be with or against? Because I need to have the two, you know, opinions. Someone who is like with having, like who agrees with having animals kept in captivity, and someone who is against that. So,
in fact, I'd like to answer the first one. I have no pet because the most animal I like very much is dog.
Dog. Okay.
I have but it's a problem to be with me in my house. As you know, some opinions say that you can't pray if you have a dog if it licks you or did anything. But I like them very much. So I have four small dogs here in, behind my building. So I get for them food and everything. You know, just going to my car, they are following me, the four dogs.
Oh, they know you.
I like them very much. I can't touch them, but they treated me as their owner.
Owner, yeah. Okay, so that's great.
I'm not absolutely with putting them in cage, any effect. Especially, okay. Of course, if you are talking about wild animals, of course, they should be. Or if they live in nature park, they live in jungle, no problem. But in any place, if they are wild animals, we should put them in cage. No one can deal with them except the one who feed them.
Okay. Yeah.
But for pets, it's a very bad thing to put dog or any pet in cages. I don't like it very much.
Okay. What about birds and you know like other pets that people keep in cages?
I think they put them. If you leave a parrot, he will fly, or it will fly.
Hmm.
Just parrots. You can. Well, I feel bad. When I feel the worst feeling when I see them in cage.
Okay.
You know, every spirit of them or every, they are souls as us. I don't know the
maybe it's their nature,
the definition, but they are they can live with us freely. No, I don't think that any of them would like to be in cage. So yeah. It's bad. It's very bad.
Okay. Now I want you to stay on the line. Let's have Hanan. I'd like to say the opposite opinion. I know you might be agreeing with Usama, but I just want.
No, I'm against. Totally against.
Okay, great. So let's hear Hanan.
I'm totally against keeping any kind of animal in a cage, whatever this kind of bird or even if it is wild. Mm. So wild, let it live in its nature, in the place that it can live in. Our creator created, or Allah created all these animals in a kind of nature to be suitable to live in this place, in the jungle or in the woods or in the desert, wherever. But if I try to change this nature and keep them in a cage, give them special kind of food, I will give them a special kind of water, a special kind of environment it will be in. Mm. So this is against nature, against its nature as an animal.
Okay.
So why do we keep them in cages? Like the way that we that happened to us during the pandemic and COVID-19, we were like animals kept in houses. Sorry if I do this similarity, but we were like prisons. For example, we kept in houses. We cannot go out. We cannot go buy or shop or go for our jobs or working. Wherever, any place. So this made us like feel angry, feel nervous, worried. So what do you think about an animal? Allah created this animal to live in nature, in the wood and the desert. So why do we keep them? Why do we prevent them to live this natural life Allah gave them? For example, we will tell that maybe the wild animals, we want to watch them in the zoo, so we keep them in cages.
Okay. Yeah.
It's okay. We can watch them in the open parks.
Okay.
So the open parks, I think it's better than keeping them in cages. If we want to own a bird, so it means that we will be happy, but this bird is not gonna be happy.
Okay. Yeah, so you're
this totally... bird will be prevented from its natural way of life. Allah created them. How much this cage is big? What I think it's not that much like the open air. That is my
You know, when you said that you're totally against, I thought you're totally against Usama's opinion. But it's
no,
like
Usama,
both of you,
Usama says,
yeah, so you
no,
both
no,
agree.
Usama says, okay. Yes, Usama says that if it is wild, we can keep them in the in the cages. Okay. But it's my opinion. No, even if it is wild, why do we keep them in cages?
No.
We're
going
to watch them.
I didn't mean it. I just, if they are in the zoo, if they are in a place that you... maybe you may meet the people like African park, like any of these places. It's very dangerous. But I'm totally with you in being in nature. They should live freely.
I'm not against your opinion, Usama. But my opinion is. Even those who are putting these, and you know, Usama, that I hate going to the zoo. I don't like to go to the zoo, not because I don't want to watch the animals, but because I want to watch the animals or see the animals. Yeah. Yes,
yeah,
like present or captivated or put in the cages. Once I went with my children, and it was a school trip to the zoo. And I found I was looking at the tigers and the lions in the cages. They are going right and left, walking to the sides, so going up and down, or moving from side to side. I felt like, what is this animal is thinking?
Yeah.
What is in his mind now? What is he thinking about the people who are putting him in that cage and those people who are looking and watching at him? I don't know. Maybe this is something strange that I'm thinking about, but I feel pity. Like, why? Why do we change? I hate anyone who changes my nature. So why shall I change the nature of others, even if it's an animal?
Okay, and well, I have a question.
Human being to gain money. It's as usual, human being to gain money.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Sure.
It's very.
Sure. We are not against.
Yeah. I'm totally with your opinions.
Opinions.
Yeah. Yes. What about? Well, I have just a question for two of you. What about people who say that we keep them in cages or we just try to prepare, some kind of place or nature that is close to their nature, maybe in the forest or something? What do you think about that? Like I went to the zoo here in Ireland, and I found them especially for the wild animal, they have like a very big place for them. It's similar to their, the forest or something. And then, but that it's still it's a prison for them. You know, it's not as big as staying in the forest. Yes, it's limited. Well, and I know also that. I read before that especially the wild animals who are predators, they have to run, like otherwise their muscles and everything they might deform or something. So but what do you think, like if we said that we're gonna prepare some nature that is close to their nature, would you agree that we can keep them in captivity, or would that change your opinion? Okay, ladies first. Okay, we'll start with Hannah, and then we'll have Osama.
Okay, if it is that big, the same, like similar, like the place that they are living in, I think it's okay, but still it's limited.
Yeah.
It's limited. But these open parks, I think it's bigger than the limited areas in the zoo, because the zoo is a limited area. Okay. But in these open parks, they for example, for the giraffe, it needs a very big place to run. Mm. So we cannot. I think it's not open. Or sorry, it's not
big. Maybe
like. Accommodating area that can be made for in the zoo. I don't know.
Okay.
I mean that it's in the zoo, it's a limited area, so it's not an enough place to let the giraffe to run, for example.
Okay. And Osama, what do you think?
No, I'm with this opinion. I feel it's not limited area. Nature parks are very wide for them. They will live freely. There's a place to live, there's water, they are in safe from preying on preying animals or wild animals. They have food, they have water, they have all they need, and they have fresh air. They can look at the sky. There's no cage. But it's a very I think it's very useful. Okay. The most important thing is that they will live safely.
Okay.
There's no wild animals that prey on it or can fight with it. They're just the same.
Okay.
I think it will be. A safe place for them.
Okay, you know what? I really like this kind of debate. Well, the idea of listening to two different opinions, or even like you and Hanan, first you agreed with something, but when we raised another issue or another question, you have a different. And we are not here, to convince each other about something. We're just, we would like to. Hear the different opinions. So that is great.
Yeah, but you should tell us about your opinions, Ms. Nance.
Well, I don't know. Well, I don't like to have...
Very good, Osama.
Good question. Yes. So my opinion about keeping animals in captivity, is that what you want to ask me?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think I think animals are like not just like not like human, but the like every living creature needs freedom. So I don't believe like we should, especially birds and, you know, like the pits that you keep in a very small cages. So I don't think
I am actually
yeah, like convinced with your opinion and Hanan's opinion, you know. Well, she said it's quite limited for them, and you said like it's safe.
No, you should be on one side. No, it's not allowed. You should be on one side. And don't be a feminist.
No, I'm just trying. I'm actually trying to. Well, no,
Miss Nancy, remember that I missed you also, not just Miss Hannah.
Just Hannah.
So don't be a feminist.
No, I'm just.
Nancy now is in the gray area.
Yeah. I'm just trying. Well, honestly, both of you gave a very, very nice debate, and like both opinions are actually convincing to me. Like I say, she said it's limited area, and it is limited area for animals, and you said it's safe and you can guarantee that you gave them food, they are away from predators, from, you know, animals that can attack them. I see that both of them, but it's good that I'm not in control of, you know, deciding to keep animals in captivity or not, you know. I'm not in control of that, but I really like, you know, hearing both of you. I can't go with any opinion.
You know, Nancy, also people need to watch these kind of animals, live animals. It means real ones. So it's not easy also to go to these open parks or the jungle or these places that these kind of animals live in. Mm. So I know that it's out of hand to do this. Yes. They need to bring these kinds of animals, but they need the people to be safe when they are watching these animals.
Yes, yeah, of course.
So,
yeah.
So it's...
You're absolutely right.
Like a dilemma.
And Osama, you're absolutely right. So it's good. I'll just mute both of you now before you try to push me to say my opinion.
Thank you.
It's good. It's good to be the host of the meeting, you know?
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Hanan and Osama. That was a really great debate. I really like it. Thanks very much. Okay, so actually we it's already here 7 past 11, but I see Yara want to participate with us. So and Noura. Okay, so Yara, I'll just have Noura first because she hasn't spoken. Okay, Noura, just feel free to unmute yourself.
Hello, this is my first time with you.
Great, and, welcome to the class.
I already like you.
Thanks very much, Noura. Tell me, Noura, what do you think?
Before we speak about cages, when you speak about wild animals and the people keep them, I think people in this point, they want to show their power, or they want to, I don't know, feed their ego maybe. It means they look, I have a tiger, I'm so strong.
You're answering that question about people who own.
I think about that. Mm. And about cages, I love animals in cages.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm with that completely.
Okay.
But birds, no. Because birds like to fly. I think it's so unfair for them if we keep them in cages.
So what about other animals?
No, keep them in cages. Keep them away.
Okay, so tell me, what kind of animals you think that we should keep in cages? And what other?
No, especially wild animals. I mean lions, tigers, this kind of animals. I think it's better for humans to be there in their wild.
Okay, but you know, Noura, I know that you might be thinking that they might be a threat to humans,
yes.
Right?
Yes, that's what I mean.
Okay, but do you know that
maybe if they stay in their jungles, it's okay.
Okay,
keep them there. But if you want to put them in the city or zoo or open parks, no, I'm not with that. I think it should be in cages because it's dangerous.
Okay, but do you know that people actually traveled sometimes to some areas like in Africa or something to get you know, special kind of animals from there. And then they travel yeah. with them to keep them in a zoo, in a city. Like, I mean, when you say that it's okay to keep them in cages, this do you agree that people like travel and get animals from their
own? No. I'm not okay. with that. Okay. I don't know how to explain my point very clearly.
No, I'm just raising a question. I'm just asking you. So do you think it's okay to do that?
No, this is not okay. If they bring them to the cities and cage them, no, it's not right. Okay. But in some, like in Africa or in jungles, there's people lived there.
Yeah.
They should be protected. Oh. They should protect themselves. So if any animals try to attack them or something, they should protect themselves.
Okay.
Because they should cage the animals. They should put them in cages. Because I think they are dangerous for the people, for kids, for
whatever. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I got your point. Thanks very much, Nora, for your participation. And we meet every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Ireland time, 10 p.m. Egypt time, and 11 p.m. Saudi Arabia time. So we would be glad to have you next week.
At time. Of course. On the same link, right?
Yeah. Yes. The same link every week.
Okay. Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Thanks very much, Nora. Okay, guys, we're actually okay. So let's have Yara. Yara, you have 1 minute to say your opinion because we have to finish now.
Okay. My opinion is I don't like to keep animals in cages. Actually, there are places like in wild animals in jungle, you know, or forest. Anywhere they can run, they can fly.
Yeah,
but I don't like the cages. They kept their freedom. They can do what they need to do. You know.
Okay. Yeah. And what about nature zoo? Like an or when people create a place.
A zoo?
Yeah. What about the open parks? What about open parks?
Yeah, actually, animals? Yeah. Open parks are just for human. Enjoy, you know, they make them joy, so they have to keep them in cages. But I think that it's not appropriate, you know. I don't think it take these animals and put them in cage just to make people come see it, you know.
Okay.
Yeah. I just don't like it.
Yeah,
there are places in jungle. Yeah.
Okay, great. Thanks very much, Yara, for your participation, and it's really nice to hear. To hear you all talking about, you know, or expressing your opinion about this. So thanks very much. And I'll just meet everyone. So I'd like to thank you all for, participating in the class. And we have new faces this class. So I'm glad that you're all joining us today. Hopefully we will meet next week at the same time. And this is a recorded meeting, so I will upload it on YouTube straight after the class. And for those who joined us for the first time, you can watch the previous sessions on my YouTube channel. This is, I forgot to say that at the beginning, but this is class number 16. So we've been running this class for more than 3 months now, which is great. I'm really happy to join you. So thanks very much for your participation, and I will see you all, hopefully all of you join us next week. So Hanan saying thank you, Samar saying thank you, Osama saying thanks for your efforts. Thanks to you all for joining the class today, and see you next Wednesday. Assalamu alaikum.